Good day everyone, so welcome again to my educational channel. So today I will discuss forensic ballistics. So it's under the components of the criminalistic area. So when we say criminalistics, that is study of criminal things by means of instrumentation. When we say instrumentation, that is the device or equipment that is being used in the examination of physical evidences. Usually, it is done in the laboratory. Okay. Kasi sa investigation, there were an evidence that cannot that needs an instrument to examine, which not possible by the investigator. For example, the blood in the crime scene. So you cannot say that blood is from the human. So pwede na siya sa animals. So that's why there are a lot of evidence needs in the examination by means of instrumentation. Most especially yung allegedly drugs nga na-recover sa crime scene. So you cannot say that is a drugs. Allegedly lang na siya. So how are we going to confirm whether that alleged drug is really a genuine drug? So we need instrument to examine that one. So dito na papasok si criminalistic. So but today I will going to discuss the forensic ballistic. So what mean by forensic? So forensic meaning anything that denotes the knowledge of the law. Okay, so forensic is coming from the Latin word marketplace, meaning to say, okay, public discussion or disputation. So it is usually done in court. So they are going to present an evidence, then they are also going to conduct examination. Okay, especially the judge. So next is ballistic. So the meaning of ballistic is the science of motion of projectile. Meaning to say, science is that is study of knowledge. So motion, that is movement. Projectile, that is metallic or non-metallic propelled by the firearm. So meaning to say, forensic ballistic is study of the motion of projectile. So ibig sabihin yan, ang ballistic daw is nag-aaral sa galaw ng bala. Okay. So may tatlong okay, before that, so saan ba to galing yung word na ballistic? Kasi yung word na ballistic hindi yan nag-originate sa atin. So galing yan sa salitang balo or balin. So that is Greek word meaning to say to throw. So ibato, ilabay. Next is, okay, another word na galing yung salitang ballistic is yung balista. Balista is a Roman word which means a giant bow or catapult. Yung balista, ito yung Roman war machine noong unang panahon. So, anong halimbawa nito? So, ito yung tinatawag na balista. So, maglalagay sila ng malaking bato dyan, yung may kalayo, so ilabay na siya dito sa castle. So, makita nyo na salida nga tong Troy, tong Battle of the Five Armies. So, yan. Then, next is, okay, balikan muna natin. Okay, sige. Forensic ballistic. Ano ba ibig sabihin ng forensic ballistic? Papasok lang si forensic ballistic kapag may nangyaring crime na involve yung firearms. Okay? So, take note, papasok lang si forensic ballistic kapag may crime na involve yung mga barrel. So, meaning to si sa forensic ballistic, a science of investigation and identification of firearms and ammunition used in the commission of crime. So, meaning to say, so, forensic ballistic is the, okay, when we say fingerprint kasi, focus sila sa fingerprint, sa crime scene. Forensic ballistic, focus sila sa mga, focus sila sa pag-identify sa firearms and ammunition used in the commission of crime. Okay. So, paano ba natin ma-identify yung firearm sa crime scene? Okay. So, yeah, ma-identify natin yan. Okay. So, at the same time, yung mga ammunition, by looking at the cartridge case or the slug or the empty shell, we can identify what kind of caliber and what kinds of firearms being used in the crime scene. Okay, next, motion of projectile. So, di ba yung ballistic is study of motion of projectile. So ang galaw, so ballistic, i-study siya ng galaw ng bala. So, may tatlong galaw o movement yung bala. Una is yung direct motion. Pangalawa, rotary motion. Pangatlo, transitional or translational motion. So, by the way, huwag yung kalimutan ha. Yung projectile, ibig sabihin ng projectile, anything, metal or non-metal, propelled by the firearms. Meaning to say, ang projectile is yung bala na pinalipad by means of firearms. So, either metal na siya or non-metal. So, motion of projectile. So, the basic example of projectile is, yeah, bala or the bullet. So, tatlong movement ang bullet. Una, yung direct motion. Forward motion of the bullet. Okay? Diretso labas sa kanang pusil. Din na po tayo tawag rotary motion. Meaning to say, yung bala, paglipad ng bala is ning tuyok siya. Okay, halimbawa, ganito. So, ang movement sa bala is mutuyok siya, mutuyok, so rotary. So, ano kaya yung dahilan kung bakit, or ngano mutuyok man ang bala? So, ang dahilan yan is gumikan aning itawag o kaning rifling. Okay, mamaya i-discuss ko sa inyo yung ano ba yung rifling. Okay, next is transitional at saka, yeah, translational. So, meaning to say, action bullet once it hits an object or target subsequently ricocheted. So, when we say ricocheted, bouncing of the bullet once it hits the target. So, ibig sabihin, pag lupad sa bala, pag igo sa target mo, balik. Muricochet siya. So, ang minungda na pasibula na is takahit siya o hard target o hard object. That's why ning bounce back siya. So, that is the third movement of sa bala. Okay. So, ikaduha, itong rotary motion, mutuyok ang bala. The primero is direct motion. Diretso lang siya lupad. What type of motion wherein the bullet will bounce back once it hits the target? So, the answer is... Okay, letter D, transitional, mubalik, mubounce back. What do you call wherein the bullet will bounce back once it hits the target? So, mubalik naman eh. Ricochet or ricocheted. Okay, nakalalibad lang ko. Okay, branches of ballistic. So, there are four branches of ballistic. So, una is tinatawag na interior ballistic or internal ballistic. Pangalawa is yung exterior ballistics or interior ballistic. Then, pangatlo is terminal at saka yung forensic ballistic. Okay, kapag sinabi natin interior ballistic, so nag-aaral siya sa bullet still inside the firearm. So, balikan natin ha. Branches of ballistic, di ba? Ang ballistics is pag-aaral sa galaw ng bala. So, when we say internal ballistic, yung bala is naapa siya sa sulod sa firearms. Exterior ballistic or internal ballistic, yung bala is nana siya sa or ninggawas na siya sa firearms. Outside na. Then, when we say terminal ballistic, so, paggawa sa bala, automatically maigo niya ang target. Bullet hits the target. Then, forensic ballistic, dyan napapasok si the science of firearms identification by means of ammunition fired through them. So, mag-investigate na si forensic ballistic kasi may krimen na nangyayari. Kapag sinabi natin interior, exterior, terminal, so may nagpabuto o naay nagpinusilay. So, papasok si forensic ballistic. So, isa-isahin natin ito. Okay. Okay, para na ako Okay, alam nyo ba na yung isang kanyo ng sundalo, tinatawag nila ng tube, one tube. So ito. Ito i-illustrate ang branches of, para masabta na ito, branches of ballistic. So this is the, okay, canyon, bangag. Okay, this is the muscle of the kanang barrel. So yung isang canyon, may naana siya ligid, diba? Okay, ligid. One ligid. Okay. Yung huna-huna rehugaw, pero dili ra na isa ka ligid, duha na ka ligid. Okay, this is the wheel. Okay. So if yung bala is nandito pa siya sa canyon, napadri ang bala, okay, tinatawag yang internal ballistic, internal. Okay, pag lumabas na ang bala, okay, ang tawag dyan is external. External. Okay, pag naigo na niya ang target, kanimoy target diri dapita, ang tawag dyan is terminal. Okay, terminal ballistic. So usay tawag ani tanan niya if mahitabo ni siya. So akonos amo sulod si forensic ballistic since na inagpabuto, so ibig sabihin na inagpinusilay. So papasok diyan si forensic ballistic. Papasok si forensic ballistic if mahitabo ni siya tanan. So nasabtan mo, so muna siya ay short explanation about sa terminal sa branches of ballistic. Okay, let us proceed. So what is interior ballistic or internal ballistic? So since the bala is nandyan pa siya sa sulod sa firearm, so nandyan si firing pin hitting the primer. So si firing pin hitting the primer. So what makes firing pin nga muduot siya dito sa primer? Because of the hammer. So what push the hammer? Ang hinungdan na si, or kisay nag-push ni hammer, si trigger. So okay, then after that one, ignition of the priming mixtures. So doon sa bala, sa cartridge or the ammunition, ang lubot ana is that's primer. So if maigo na siya sa firing pin, automatically si priming mixture is mag-ignite. Ignite means to say, muinit. So, muto hinungdan, anong mag-combustion ang gunpowder. Masunog ang gunpowder. Then, the gunpowder will turn to expanded heated gas or turn to explosive gas. Okay? So since nga expanded gas, kinahanglan iduot niya kinsa iyang maduot. Okay? So before na siya iduot niya ng bala, so naay madevelop dira nga pressure. So pressure. So next ana is energy generated, then automatically recoil of the gun. So pressure develop. So pag develop sa pressure, siyempre kinahanglan ipagawas na niyang bala, kumbaga kung suko na kay ka ba, kinahanglan ipagawas nimo. So gawas sa bala. So energy generated, so depende na kung kusog kayo na nga caliber, kusog po ng energy. So ana na siya, then recoil of the gun, yung bounce back, rearward movement sa imuha. Then we have also the velocity of the bullet inside the barrel. So velocity meaning to say that is the speed of the bullet inside the barrel sa paggawas niya. So meaning to say ang velocity magdepende po na sa firearms, high power firearms. Okay, mga hard power na firearms, automatically taas ang iyang energy. Automatically, ang velocity po niya is grabe ka paspas. May kag velocity, that is speed of the bullet inside the barrel. So next, rotation of the bullet inside the barrel. If ang firearms gigamit na siya'y rifling, morotate ginang bala. Then we have engraving of the cylindrical surface of the bullet. Kasi yung rifling inside the barrel is may land and grooves na tinatawag dyan. So inig labay sa bala, automatically mo engrave tong land and groove na marking dre sa bullet. Okay, next is exterior or internal ballistic. So yung bala is lumabas na sa barrel. So anong mayroon dyan? So mayroon tinatawag tayong muzzle blast. So when we see muzzle blast, that is the sound created at the muzzle end of the barrel. So muscle blast, so ang kusog na buto. So depende kung hard power yung firearms, kusog ang muscle blast. Kung hinay ang dili kay mga high power firearms, automatically hinay ang muscle blast ana niya. Then next we have the muscle energy. So ang energy magdepende gyapon. So when you say energy is power generated after leaving the firearms. So kung ang energy sa bullet is or kana nga bullet gikan nasa sa mga high power firearms, automatically taas kay energy. Okay? Kumbaga kusgan kaayo. Pero kanang galuya, hinay kay siya energy. So ana ra na siya. Next we have the trajectory. When we see trajectory, that is the path of the bullet or core pattern in flight. So okay, ganito yan trajectory. Okay. Yung actual curve pattern of the flight. So pag if this is the firearms, kani mo'y firearms. So ang trajectory ana is actually pa actual curve na siya. Okay? Why man? Because of the gravity of the kanang gravity. So magkaanam gina siya o ka down. So that is what called trajectory. Next is we have the range. Okay, range is distance between the muscle and the target. So saan dito ang range? Ang range is gikan diri sa firearms kani og paingon diri sa target. Ang distance ana niya kana gitawag na siya og range. Okay, gikan sa muscle of dagan, yung kag muscle of dagan katong bangag sa barrel. Okay, paingon diya sa target. So this is the target. So tawag ana niya range. Actual curve, that is trajectory. Okay, so muna siya ibot pasabot. So may kag range, there are four kinds of range. So una nga range is okay, dito muna tayo. So when we see velocity, that is the speed of the bullet. So ang kapaspason sa bullet gyapon nagdepende gyapon na sa firearm. So kung hard mga high power firearms, automatically ang velocity niya is paspas kaayo. Pero sa mga opposite sa mga hard power firearms, just like sa mga shotgun, dili kay na siya kana ang velocity niya sa bullet is dili kayo paspas. Okay? So next is the gravitational pull. So when we say gravitational pull, that is the responsible of the downward movement of the bullet. So the gravity is the reason why the bullet makes or turn to downward movement. Kaya nga yung mga sniper guys, kung kabantayan mo, dito na sila mag-position ibabaw sa building. Kaya nga nung sa ubos man sila, kung sa ubos man good sila, may tabuan na if ang travel sa bala man good is what? Dili siya accurate, possible, paspas yang kanang yang accurate sa iyang bala man good, dili maigo gyud niya ba kung naasa, kung sa tong nasa cross, di gito niya ma-target gyud because of the gravity. That's why sa ibabaw na sila nag-position para naaslay accurate nga target. Ang reason mong guna na is ang gravity. So if nakas ibabaw, automatically the gravity will help the bullet nga to have accurate target. So balik ta sa range. So na itulog ka klase nga range. Una is yung tinatawag na maximum range. When we say maximum range is muna siya ay pinaka hangganan sa bala gikan sa firearms. Okay, if this is the firearms kana. Okay, firearms na siya. Money target. So, gikan diri sa muscle of the gun. So, kung aharataman ang bala, is gitawag na siya og maximum range. So, ahataman ang bala. Saan ang ganan ng bala? When we say effective range, effective lang na siya if maigo ni mo ang target. Kung ang target is tawo, ma-injured ni mo siya or mapatay ni mo siya. Then when we say maximum effective range, so naagya po tayo word nga effective range. But pasabot ana niya, bisan pa tuod og layo kay imong target, naigo gyapon nimo siya. Okay? Layo kay imong target but naigo gyapon nimo siya. Okay, example, imong target. So naigo nimo na siya. So that is what you call maximum effective range. So mura siya ay kalainan sa tulo. Next is the air resistance. So under gapo na sa internal ballistic. So air resistance, that is the resistance encountered by the bullet while in flight. So ito yung problema. To ha, in order to overcome this problem, nga dili matandog or ma-resist ang air sa bala, that's why yung mga barrel class may tinatawag na rifling. So ang rifling is one way to resist the air. So rifling, so ang rifling is pakita na siya sa inside sa gun barrel. Okay, naana dia, gatuyok na siya. Okay, so that's why inigagi sa bala dra is mutuyok. That is one reason to overcome the kana resistant or to overcome the air. So para ma-resist ang bala sa air. So next, penetration. When you see penetration is ay nilapos siya sa target, deep of entry. Next, we have terminal ballistic. So focus tayo sa terminal ballistic. When we see terminal ballistic is meaning to say ang bala niabot na dito sa target. So unsay naa diha? So una is natay tawag terminal accuracy. Okay? Size of the bullet, grouping on the target. So yung bullet is mahibal-an mo na siya unsay resulta na if maigo na ang target. So next we have the terminal energy. So mahibal-an mo na terminal energy kung dito sa target. Kung target na bungkag, grabe ug pagka grabe ka guba sa target. So meaning to say ang energy sa bullet is grabe ka taas. Okay, energy of the bullet upon hitting target. So kung bungkag kay na siya, so automatically grabe ang energy ana sa bullet. So we have also the terminal penetration. So deep of the bullet entry into the target. So meaning to say if ang bullet dia is nakalusot gud sa target, so grabe ang energy ana at the same time yung velocity. So galing yan sa matataas na caliber ng baril. So we have also the terminal velocity. So muna siya, yung kapaspason sa bala. Yung velocity is the rate of speed of the bullet upon hitting the target and penetrate it. Okay. So di rata malibog na ha. Velocity, that's speed of the bullet. Okay, penetration, yung paglubong sa bala. Okay. Accuracy, that is the accurate sa target. So may balaan na siya sa size sa bullet pod. Kung maigo ba din niya ang target. Then we have also the terminal energy. So next, proceed tayo ni forensic ballistic. So papasok na si forensic ballistic kasi may nangyaring krimen na ang ginagamit is yung barrel. So when we say field ballistic, so meaning both pasabotan na niya, the investigator, the ballistician will investigate on the crime scene. Field investigation, nandyan yan sa crime scene. So they are the one or to gather an evidence. Nag-marking sila, nag-tagging sila, nanguligtas lang mga evidence diha. Then we have also the technical examination. When we see technical examination, technical, that is device or equipment used in examination in the physical evidence. Usually it is done or mahitabo na siya sa laboratory. Kani nga picture. This is technical examination. Yung mga na-gathered na evidence during sa field investigation, dadalhin yan sa laboratory to examine. Because sabi ko nga kanina, nga, na yung mga evidence nga dili makaya sa mga investigator nga makahatag sila conclusion. For example, drugs. Dili man makaingon sila nga drugs ginailang nakuha sa crime scene. So in order to confirm nga really that allegedly drugs is genuine drugs, so we need an equipment or technical devices to examine the that specific evidence. So that is what called confirmatory test. So ikandaka nato na confirmatory test sa laboratory. So dira ra ma-examine nato kung tinuod ba nga drugs na siya or dili. Then whatever the result of the examination, that is will use in the court. Gamiton yan sa court, the person or the one who kana examine the evidence will consider as an expert witness and called to testify in court to kanang yeah, to report the final examination or to report unsa iyang na come up sa iyang examination sa laboratory. So that is legal proceeding. But yung mga expert witness, dili na sila makaingon yun nga sila siya ay gapatay, iyaha na nga fingerprint, ilaha lang, nag-rely lang na sila sa base ilang examination. Nga example, nakuha nga drugs atong crime scene is really a genuine drugs. Ang nakuha nga fingerprint ana nga kuan is mauni siya, kang kuan ni siya, kang Juan de la Cruz. But dili na siya mingon nga si Juan de la Cruz nagpatay. Iya lang i-state dito nga ayang nakuha nga mga evidence is kahong Juan de la Cruz ni. Okay, ana lang. So nag-rely na sila sa examination. So that is what called investigation is a science. Okay, na yung mga evidence nga dili mahatagan og kanang conclusion sa mga investigator. So we need laboratory examination. Diyan papasok si forensic ballistic. So again, there are three division of forensic ballistic. We have the field investigation, usually may tabo sa crime scene, technical examination may tabo sa laboratory, legal proceeding dito na sa court. Okay, whatever the result after the examination of the expert witness will be used in court. So mag-testify na siya dito. Can we consider magazine as a firearm? Okay? So, makonsider mo na ito ang magazine as a firearm. The answer is, okay, let us first define firearms under Public Act 10591. This is the latest definition of firearms under this law. So, this is the Section 3, definition of terms, refers to any handheld or portable weapon, whether of small arms or light weapons that expel or designed to expel a bullet, shot, slug, missiles, or any projectiles which is discharged by means of expansive force of gases coming from the what? Okay. Expansive force gases, burning gunpowder, or the other form of combustion of any similar instrument or implement. For the purpose of this act, barrel, frame, or receiver is considered as a firearm, but magazine is not considered as firearm. This is the legal definition of firearms. Next, we have also the technical definition. Instrument used for the propulsion. Propulsion, gipalupad ang bala pinaagi sa expansive force gases coming from the gunpowder. Okay, that's the technical definition of fire. So there are three laws nga about sa relating to firearms. Una, yung PD 1866, kang Marcos pa ni. Then we have also the RA 8294, giamindahan niya ang 1866. Then kanipod si RA 10591, so giamindahan po niya si 8294. So next. Okay, origin of firearms. So asa ni nag-originate ang firearms? Actually, ga-originate ang firearms okay, in Western Europe. Then, kanisi Berthold Schwartz, a German monk, and Roger Bacon, Landoa, sila mo'y naka-discover po about sa gunpowder. Because after the discovering of the firearms, it followed the what? The gunpowder. But the gunpowder, ilang na-invention dere is katong black powder. So, yung black powder is giabolish ni siya after because kani mangong black powder mo emit ni siya og mga gases nga toxic, the same time grabe pong asuan niya, so that's why gilisdan ni siya. So next is we have the following are the stages of development of what kanang man's weapon. Una is the knives, next the spear and darts, slingshot to hurl object. Dili ni katong tiradora kay wa pa may guma sa unang panahon. The stone, the clubs, bows and arrows, crossbows, guns dayon, then pinakalasis na missile. So development stages. Next is we have the men behind the firearms. So siyempre na again ng mga tao nga behind sa firearms. Una si Colonel Calvin H. Goddard. Okay? So he is the colonel of the US Army. Kinatawag din siya nating consider po nato siya nga pattern of modern ballistic, si Calvin H. Goddard. Next, we have the Horace Smith, founded the great firm Smith and Wesson and pioneered the making of breech loading revolver. Tapos muna sila. Then next, we have also the Daniel B. Wison, an associate or partner of Smith in revolver making. So silang Horace Smith mo yung nakakuha-discover, ana. John M. Browning, so wizard and of modern firearms and pioneered breech loading rifle making. Okay, ato rin may balaan nun niya katong mga ani mga firearms. Then we have also John T. Thompson, pioneered the making of Thompson submachine gun. Okay, we have also the David Kirby Williams, so maker first known as carbine or carbine. We have also si Alexander John Forsett, father of percussion system. Okay, ato nang kanon niya. Then we have also si Elisha Kingroth, design machinery of making Colt 45. Then Ilipalit Remington, one of the first rifle makers. We have also si James Wolf Ripley, stimulated the development of model 1855 rifle musket. Samuel Colt produced the first practical revolver. Si Henry Deringer gave his name to a whole classes firearms. We have also the John C. Garan designed the semi-automatic U.S. rifle caliber 30. Then we have the last Oliver M. Winchester, one of the earliest rifle and pistol maker. Okay, next is the main types of firearms, size of projectile propel. Okay. So when you see size of projectile, so that is the okay, mamaya na lang. Okay, there are two main types of firearms according sa ilahang projectile size sa projectile propel. Una is we have the artillery. Ato sa ni gaan sa tamo idea. If this is the barrel, this is the bullet. Okay, this is the bullet. Okay, ba ato sa ilistan ha. If this is the bullet, bullet na siya. Okay. Okay. Ang diameter, yung ingon mga diri is size of projectile propelled. So, kung ang bullet gani is more than 1 inch diameter. So, ang diameter is gikan sa ibabaw, paingon sa ubos. Kana ba? Measurement diha. Gitawag na siya o what? Caliber. Okay, caliber. Caliber. If ang size gani niya sa projectile or the bullet is more than gani siya 1 inch diameter, kaning balaha is pang artillery na siya. Kung minto say dagko nga bala, kay more than 1 inch diameter man, so kanang nga bala is pang artillery na siya. Okay? Pero ang diameter sa bala, oh this is the example of the artillery nga mga bala, dagko masag bangag di sa kuan ko do, barrel niya. But if ang bala is less than gani siya, ang bala is less than na siya o what? 1 inch, less than. What diameter? So ang bangag sa bala or ang baril niya, kada ang sukod sa baril niya is less than gani siya 1 inch diameter, kana nga bala is intended na para sa small arms. So small arms. So dili but sabot nga kaning small arms is kanang mga gagmayng pusil, no. We are referring about the projectile bala, ang diameter sa bala. Kung ang diameter sa bala less than gani sa 1 inch, pang small arm na siya. Pero ang bala is more than 1 inch gani, what? Aha na siya, pang artillery na siya, pang artillery. Okay, mura na siya ay timelan. So sa meantime sa firearms, artillery is small arm. Artillery is ang diameter sa bala is more than 1 inch. Small arms, ang diameter sa bala is less than 1 inch. Okay, next is posi tayo sa classification of firearms. So we have the manner of feeding. So pag feed sa ammunition. Okay, we have the muzzle loading firearms. So muzzle dito sa bangag i-butang ang ammunition. So the example anis kaning musket. We have also the magazine loading firearms. So ang ammunition is dito isaksak sa kanang magazine. So munisya, ammunition is fed through magazine. We have also the breech loading firearms. So bridge loading, tinawa nyo sa picture. Okay, parehas which are loaded on each bridge. Bridge niya. So iyahang kaning bangag niya ba. Okay, parehan nga niyo. Okay. We have also the link or belt weapon designed to receive cartridge in belt or length. So this is the example. We have also classification firearms, interior barrel construction. Okay. So sa interior barrel construction, we are referring to the kanang barrel. So classification of firearms sa barrel. So interior barrel construction, giunsa pag-construct ang barrel. Okay, we have the smoothbore firearms, firearms that have no riflings inside the barrel, just like the shotgun. Then we have also the rifle bore firearms. Firearms nga naa siya gitawag og rifling. Kato ng inside sa barrel niya, gun barrel. So, say example ani ron. Okay, this is the example. The caliber 45. We have also the kaninga firearms nga ni. So, naa na sila yung mga rifling. So, unsa ning rifling? Rifling is a number of helical grooves cut in the interior surface of the bore. The rifling in the firearms may be divided into the following types. Okay, muna siya. Okay, so muna yung rifling nga, muna makita nyo sa inside sa kanang sa bar sa barrel. So na sa murag nagtuyok. So that is rifling. So na ay gitawag dra kaning elevated portion is what we call the lan, the depressed portion that is the groove. Okay, types of rifling, we have stir type, four grooves, lan, hand twist groove, and lan of equal width. So for ang iyahang rifling, so we have also the groove and the lan, the same. Smith and Wesson type, five grooves, right hand twist. Then we have also the Browning type, six grooves. So kung ilan yung groups, ningana po ang lan para equal na siya nga size. So we have the Colt type, the Weebly type, Army type, and micro rifling type. Okay, next. Purpose of rifling. So anong na may rifling ang inside sa barrel? So the purpose is to provide motion of rotation to a bullet during its passes inside the barrel. Okay? In order to ensure the gyroscopic effect. To lumabas to sa board exam na mo ni. Okay, in flight, meaning bullet travel nose on the target. So, ang purpose ng rifling is para what? Okay, ang bullet inigawas niya sa barrel manggod is to ensure the gyroscopic effect. When we say gyroscopic, that is stable movement of the bullet. Stable kayo, straight ang dagan in flight. At the same time, to overcome also the air, kasi yung air mo number one problem basta inigawa sa bala. Kay siyempre monay ang air manggood is monay makapahinay sa bala. The same time ang target niya digid maigog mikan sa hangin. The same time also the gravity. So in order to overcome that problem, so patuyo ko nila ang bullet pinagi sa rifling. So bullet travel nose on the target. So this is the gyroscopic effect, guys. So patuyo ang purpose sa rifling, patuyo kun ang bala para naay gitawag gyroscopic effect. Meaning si gyroscopic effect stable ang travel sa bala. Straight jud kayo, maigo jud ginung target. Opposite aning gyroscopic is yung tinatawag na U. U is unstable movement the bullet. Why man? Because maybe ang barrel is ang contributor mo gud aning anong magkayo. Nganong say U unstable opposite sa gyroscopic. So loose bore ang barrel, luag ang barrel. Okay, mo sana sa epekto sa mo na nganong magkayo ang isa ka yo, magkayo ang isa ka bala, unstable ang movement niya. Okay, equivalent of the calibers in inches and milliliter. By the way, ang caliber guys is kanisya. If this is the wait sa. Oh, if maoni siya ay kanang barrel, kana barrel ni siya. Okay. Ang caliber is ang measurement sa bangag diri sa barrel. Okay, from lan to lan. Kigikan diha, paingon diha, ang measurement ana niya, that is what it called caliber. Caliber. Ano okay, this is the caliber. So ang caliber, this is the measurement of the bore diameter sa barrel. So that is the caliber. Muna, kung ang measurement gani is 6.22 inches, tawag na siya og caliber 22, bantay mo. Kung ang measurement dripod sa barrel is 0.25 inches, gitawag siya caliber 25. Another kung ang measurement is 0.32, dasay caliber 32, caliber 30, caliber 38, caliber 45. Okay? So caliber 50 din caliber 60. So ang caliber is muna measurement sa diameter sa barrel. So inches ni siya ang yang kuana, yang unit. Pwede po nato na siya i-what kanang i convert into milliliter. So sabol 9 mm. So pare-pareha ra na siya measurement sa caliber 38. So na 9 mm. Okay, we have kung 0.22 inches na siya, so pwede na ang milliliter ana niya is 5.56 milliliter. So ang banga gyapon ni ang gripper, banga gyapon ni sa barrel. Okay. Next ana niya is type of characteristic in firearms. So this will be our next topic. Thank you so much for listening. God bless.